In this video, I explain exactly what YouTube playlists are, why you should use them on your channel, and how to create new playlists that get discovered in search. At the end of the video, I also explain how playlists can greatly improve your channel's homepage's look and feel, which in turn keeps viewers looking at your videos, which can help grow your YouTube channel. Let's start at the very beginning. What is a YouTube playlist? Well, a YouTube playlist is a group of videos that someone has put together because they relate to one another in some sort of way. That could be they follow a sequence, like a series where you benefit from watching one video after the other and it follows a logical pattern. In most cases, sequences of videos are by the same creator and their aim is to help viewers logically follow from one video to another to learn a specific skill or understand a specific topic. Playlists can also be groups of similar videos. For example, a collection of videos that are all about how to build a model car. If all the videos are related to the same topic, but each video explains slightly different options or features, this will help position your YouTube video correctly in YouTube search, but also gives you the opportunity to appear on the suggested feature on YouTube. Let me explain exactly what I mean by that. So in the example of the model car, you may choose to construct a playlist that shows how to build a Ford Focus. And you also have a video already explaining how to construct a Ford Mondeo. You link these together in a playlist. You then find another creator that has a great video about Ford Mustangs. You could add this video to your playlist too. Now, I know what a lot of you are going to be thinking. As soon as the playlist hits that video, you are no longer clocking up the hours on your video and you are actually promoting somebody else's video. So why would you do that? Well, a playlist makes a link between the videos. So if your content is similar to another channel, creating those links is actually a good thing. If you imagine a spider web, and the more links you make, the larger the spider web gets, and the more likely Mr. Spider is to catch his prey, or the chance you have to hook people in to watch your videos. So the more links you create to similar creators, the better YouTube can position your videos and know exactly what you specialize in. And ultimately, it strengthens the chance of your videos showing up in YouTube's suggested features whilst viewers watch other channels' videos. If you appear in suggested more often, you'll get more clicks, more views, and more watch time. This obviously works the other way too. If somebody is watching your video, the other channel's video that's in the playlist is likely to appear in suggested. So you still need to keep the viewer engaged and watching your videos, but by linking the other channel's content via your playlist, you can really help boost your channel overall. All you need to do is make sure the content you're connecting is relevant for the viewer. And if we're meeting for the very first time, then my name is Joe Cullen, and this video is actually part of a series on how to create your YouTube channel from scratch. There's a link in the description below to the full playlist if that interests you. So why should you use a YouTube playlist? Well, as we've already discussed, there are two main reasons you may want to create a playlist. And number one is to make it easier for your viewers to follow through a series that you have made for them. The easier it is to help your viewers, the more people will like and return to your channel. By setting up a playlist that guides them through in the correct sequence, you are really making it as easy as possible for them to consume your content. And if you get your playlist to rank in search, then you're not just promoting one video on your channel, you're promoting an entire collection of videos, which when this happens, you will see massive spikes in your watch time and your subscriber count. And reason number two on why you should use playlists is to position yourself strategically and link to other channels. This simply increases people's awareness of your channel and that you exist. A lot of the time on YouTube, the main reason you are not growing is because people simply don't know that you're there. All you need to do is get people aware that you exist, and if you can get in front of more people and you're producing good content as well, a portion of them will subscribe and support your channel. One of the most underrated ways to get in front of more people is to link strategically to other videos via playlists. So how does this relate to starting a new channel? Now, let's not forget, most are watching this video to learn how to create their YouTube channel in the very best way from scratch. So lots of the information I've just given isn't actually relevant to you right now, especially if you don't have any content on your channel. However, knowing the ins and outs of playlists is important so you can build that into your strategy moving forwards. And the main reason I've started talking about them this early on in the series is because the very next video will explain how to use playlists on your homepage. And I'm guessing if you're like me, you cannot use playlists very easily if you don't know what they do, what their intentions are, or how to create them. So I hope you now understand what they are. Let's turn our attention on how to create playlists. And to do that, I'm going to jump over to the computer and show you right now. Okay, so the first thing we need to do to create a new playlist is come up to your icon in the top right and then go into YouTube Studio. Then over on the left-hand side, you see the playlists item. Click onto that. And now, as you would expect on a new channel, you've got no playlists here, but you can come up to the top right and go new playlist. When you click on that, you get two options. You need to fill in the title and then the visibility. The title wants to be something that's describing the collection of videos that you want to create. So for Ultimate Gamer, I could do something like action game reviews or RPG game reviews. So for my example, I'll use action game reviews, and this would be a collection of all the action games that I've reviewed on my channel. It could theoretically also include other people's game reviews if I wanted to add them in and create those links that I was talking about earlier. Visibility, there are three different types of visibility. The first one is public. Public means that it's open to the world and everyone will be able to see your playlist if they come to your channel. Private is the exact opposite. No one, apart from if they've got permission to your channel. So by that I mean if you've given them permission to the back end of your channel so they can work as an admin behind the scenes, they will be able to see your private playlists. But apart from that, nobody viewing your channel as a regular viewer will be able to see your private playlists. Unlisted playlists is a bit of a grey area in the middle. It can lead to a bit of confusion, so just understand that unlisted does actually mean it's available for the world to see. There's no protection and there's no security around an unlisted playlist. The only difference between an unlisted playlist and a public playlist is that public shows on your YouTube channel, whereas unlisted by default does not. So you have to provide the link to the unlisted playlist for most people to find your unlisted playlist. However, there are websites and other tools available that can surface unlisted playlists. So really what you want to do is make sure that if you've got an unlisted playlist, it's actually okay for the world to see. It's just not really relevant to them. If that's the case, then you can select unlisted playlist. But generally speaking, I would say select either public or private. You don't really want to have a playlist that's unlisted unless you've got a very specific reason for that. So I'm going to select public and I'm going to click create just here. Now that's created an item just down here, and I can hover over and click onto the pencil to get to a few more options. Now this is the title. I can edit it here if I wanted to at all.
And now I can also add a description. Descriptions are the same as videos, where you've got 5,000 characters that you can use. And I suggest using at least 1,000 characters, so it actually makes sense for people that may be interested in watching it. Now, to save time, I've already prepared a quick description for this playlist. However, it is worth noting that both the title and the description can play a part in ranking in search. So if you wanted this playlist to be discovered in search, which I'm suggesting most people would like that if they've got the option to, then you want to try and optimize both of these areas for YouTube search. Now, that's done in exactly the same way as the title and the description on a normal video, which we'll cover in a much later video. So to get up and running, I suggest just putting in what you think is best, and then we'll come back to all of this later on when you have more understanding of how to perform some SEO on your title and description. There's nothing more to it than that. After you've added in your description, just click save and your playlist is now created. All you need now is to add some videos into your playlist. So to do that, you can do it in two different ways. The first way is to click on these little dots and click add videos. You can then search for your video, or you can look in your videos. Obviously, this channel has no videos at the moment, or you can add it through a URL. You've got lots of different options. If I just add a video from one of my other channels, then it's as quick and easy as doing that. You can then reorder them as you add more videos. So the first one at the top is the one that will play first and also show as the preview for the playlist. If you come back to the little dots, you've also got some extra options here. You can add to all. So when you've got videos on your playlist, you can add them all to another area as well. You've got the collaborate, which means other people can add to your playlist. I'd recommend in most circumstances turning this off, but you may want other people to collaborate with you on making this playlist. You've also got your playlist settings. So allow embedding basically means that you can embed this playlist into your website or other areas, and other people can too. Add new videos to top of playlist, which means your first video here will become your last video if you keep on adding new videos to your playlist. In most circumstances, if you're playing through from A to Z or in a sequence, then you'd want to leave this turned off. But if you want the newest video at the front, then you can switch that on. And you can also set it as the official series for the playlist. Lastly, the final option in the list here is to delete the playlist. Now, this will not delete your videos. This will only delete the playlist, the grouping of all of the videos put together. So you can't delete your videos from this view. All it's going to do is remove this playlist, which will remove the links that you've created between all of the playlist items. Now, you may have reason to do that, and that's how you would do it. And now that we've added this video to the playlist, if we go back to our channel and then click over onto playlists, we'll now see our first created playlist in our playlist section on our channel. You can obviously create as many as you'd like, and over time I would expect channels to create quite a few playlists, not only because they're creating their own little series of videos that are helpful for their viewers, but also to create those links that we discussed earlier. So I do hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing. In the very next video in this series, we'll be talking about our homepage and how we can make this look awesome for our viewers. So I'll see you in the next video.